Jack, even early this into the season, that's a massive 3 points.
Yeah, we knew the importance of winning today simply because of the way the league table started to pan out. We also recognised that we have one of the toughest starts on paper in the league. I think when you look at the fixtures we've had to date and the ones we've got coming up, and also when you add into the fact that they haven't lost a game, Livingston haven't lost a game in such a long time, so huge result. And then on top of that, when you add the circumstances of the game into it as well.
You say the circumstances of the game, a huge abundance of character shown from the players today after going down to 10 men to then take the lead again, but then hold on at the end.
Yeah, they were outstanding, every single one of them, and they deserve all the credit, nobody else. I say often enough, they're the ones that go on the pitch, and they're the ones that had to produce that desire, character, energy levels, belief in themselves through that last hour of the game, if you like, after Gary was sent off. Delighted they got the rewards from it, delighted they repaid those fans that had travelled to Capital last week as well, and some of them here again today in large numbers, that with that type of character, performance and desire for the badge, I think, and I thought we deserved to win the game. I thought we were terrific.
Tough for us over the other side to see the red card incident. What did you make of it?
I haven't watched it again yet. Normally as a manager you always dispute them in the first instance, because naturally you don't want your team to lose a man. Speaking to some of the other players that were close to it, they felt as if it probably was a red card. I think Gary maybe said to me as well that I think he's got a wee bit frustrated at, you know, losing possession, and I think when you stretch and you have your stud shown, you're on the risk of it. I haven't watched it again, so I couldn't say for definite, but you know, from what other people have said, then there might not be too many complaints with it.
You were sent to the stands as well. I wasn't really sure what happened there. Obviously, Danny Mullen had put in a poor challenge on Stelios at the time.
I've just spoken to Craig Thompson there, somebody I've known a long time, both as a player and a manager, so we had a sensible conversation about it. I was immensely frustrated because I attended the refs meeting a couple of weeks ago where it was explained to me that if your player is on the end of a tackle that results in a caution, then he's allowed to receive treatment and stay on the pitch. However, when Stelios received treatment, he was then put off the park. So I probably didn't react in the right way because I was so frustrated. Craig's explained that that's at the referee's discretion. However, that wasn't explained to us. So I'm not disputing Craig's take on it. However, it would be good if it was explained clearly to us in the first instance, then it would perhaps prevent situations where managers become frustrated. I shouldn't leave my technical area, I accept that. But as I said, Craig and I have a sensible conversation about it. I feel as if I've always got the right to protect my team and my players, and I'll always do that and back them. So yeah, hopefully it won't come to too much, because I felt as if it was much ado about nothing, to be fair.
A bit of a makeshift defensive line today with Gary McKenzie missing out and Jack Baird suspended. What's the issue with Gary at the moment?
He suffered a knock a couple of weeks ago against Falkirk, a head knocking, so we're having that assessed at the moment. We only knew that he wouldn't make today on Thursday night, so we only had yesterday to try and prepare for playing in the way we did, the shape we did, the personnel and the areas that we're in. So players again deserve huge credit for that, because I thought we were okay with 11 men as well. We started the game quite well because it was very different for them. You know, we do a lot of preparation for games, but that was a quick turnaround for us. So to go into the game with one recognised centre half and to produce that type of performance, the players all over the pitch deserve credit, but particularly those ones playing in those makeshift back threes at times.
And that one recognised centre half, Gregor Buchanan, probably had his best game for St Mirren today, I feel. How did you see his performance?
Yeah, delighted for him personally, because he's been a bit up and down. I think he's found it difficult settling, not difficult, but he's had a period of adjustment. I like him from a personal point of view. I know he has a real hunger to try and prove himself here and play every week, so I think he recognised today was an opportunity for him to do that, and he grabbed that with both hands. I thought his performance level, and particularly as the second half wore on, where we had to defend an awful lot of crosses, and you know, before John came on the pitch, he was probably our only player above 6 foot tall, so there was a big onus on him to go and be really strong in there, and he did that, so really pleased for him individually.
Gavin Riley's good start to the season continues, another two goals for him, that must be pleasing.
Brilliant. Some people underestimate is the amount of work he had to put in off the ball today. After half an hour, it was incredible, and then still have the fitness levels and sharpness of mind to be in those positions to score the two goals, and the second one in particular, I think, is a really good finish. It's testament to how the way he looks after himself and his conditioning levels. I think I backed James and I's judgment in bringing him to the club. We'd both worked with him before, we both felt as if we could get the best from him, and he's made a really good start here, both in terms of the goals he scored and the assists he's had, and that'll continue because he enjoys it, he's comfortable where he is, fans have taken to him, and he'll be a big asset to us over the season.
Just finally, a tie to Relish next week with Dundee United coming at the Paisley 2021 stadium.
Brilliant game. I think it's a while since we've been at home because of the way the fixtures came out. The opening home game was terrific in terms of atmosphere. I would imagine it will be similar next week with the crowd that they'll bring and how our supporters will respond. And I think, as I mentioned at the beginning, I was delighted that we were able to to pay them back a little bit for last week's disappointment. I know there was 2,000 of them travelled last week. Still good numbers here again today, and I know that the group of fans that have created that banner with the fight is on, well, I think today showed that there's a group of players here that will take that mantle on for them and continue to strive to produce performances like that week in, week out.